Hey guys, welcome to another edition of Scriptly Live. I'm Kyode, your host.
Hey guys, I'm Kate. Today we are delving into what's coming up in film. Released on July 6th, Ant-Man and the Wasp came out. A much lighter Marvel film graciously delivering us from the last two heavy films that have been released, Black Panther and the latest Avengers, which were awesome, but dark.
Yeah, a little dark, but awesome, right?
I think so.
Okay, I think this film has big promise, right?
Yeah.
We haven't seen it yet. We will, though, but we haven't seen it yet. But it's definitely on my radar. It's definitely on my radar and my list of things to see. It's getting great reviews. Paul Rudd is great in the role.
Yeah.
Awesome comedic timing.
Mm-hmm.
Check out this clip.
So, how long have you been Ant-Man again?
Not long. It just sort of happened.
I wish I could fight bad guys like you.
I seem to mess it up almost every time.
Maybe you just need someone watching your back.
Hi. I haven't seen the first Ant-Man. I know, gasp. anywho, I adore Paul Rudd, and I'm happy to see it, you know, to say I've seen it, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, tell us what double feature we're going to delve into next.
So this film, we had the pleasure of seeing this past weekend, this new documentary called Whitney. It was unapologetically raw and yet very sensitive and just really well done.
It was really well done. Honestly, this film was so moving. You are so right when you say raw. I couldn't think of a better adjective. To see on screen a human being deteriorate so quickly and blatantly was heart-wrenching. I mean, it did highlight the positive aspects of her career, too.
Of course, yeah.
But, you know, it was mostly, I mean, I think
sad.
The bulk of her life was catastrophic, really. Mm-hmm. I really think what made this film even more powerful was that you had her immediate family members appear in the film giving their testimonials.
Now, those testimonials were honest,
yes,
I would say.
Yes, very.
So I totally agree with you. It was a real authentic look into the rise and fall of a major musical icon. Not just musical, but she
everything.
Got into film.
Yeah.
I mean, The Bodyguard with Kevin Costner.
It was her aura and it was her presence. Like, she had a very... But it was weird because when you saw her regularly, like off set or off stage, mm-hmm. she was very humble, very mild mannered, very like soft spoken almost.
Right. It was almost to the
like
point where
people.
It was almost to the point where she almost downplayed how great she was in some cases.
She wasn't used to it, I don't think.
She wasn't used to it, but she was an amazing icon. Will be missed in music, of course.
You know, real quick, this might be a little too deep, but I almost got the sense that Sissy Houston was more of the star than Whitney was, in the sense where Sissy was used to that, and that's what she wanted, that's what she lived for. I don't know.
That's what
if
she
Whitney
worked to
really,
get to, which was what Whitney's level was.
And I don't know if Whitney really wanted that iconic status. So it was interesting. I enjoyed it.
Great film.
Yeah.
Guys, we leave you with this clip from Whitney. Until next time, later.
See ya. Love you.
Bittersweet memories, that is all.